We got a lot of our cores. Still missing on Bergslagen though. Smolena. But not bad. Not bad actually. And we're not allies with Brandenburg anymore, but we can be once that, you know, annul treaty thing wears off. So in the meantime, I guess hang on, can make more states. Meantime, though, let's keep repaying some loans. Let's put our army back, maintenance back down, and turn our forts off. Go back to trade. I actually forgot to have that on war the whole time. I could get another colonist. Oh, that'd be helpful. What do I do? What do I do? Should I get another colonist? I mean, I don't know if I can even afford another colonist, really. But I could. Let's see, I got the one going already. It's actually making pretty good work here. I get 70 per year, which is pretty dang good, actually. Bohemia's still not interested in an alliance. I'm still not getting any stupid diplomatic relation or diplomatic reputation monarchs. But I'm going to keep my guy there because I really want Bohemia as an ally. They'd be super helpful as an ally. Doubt Austria is interested at all. Or France. France, definitely not. Yeah, Russia's not interested in going with me either. But what about the Ottomans? I mean, probably not, but yeah, probably not. Even though I like them. And Hungary, they were rivals with Hungary. Everyone hates me. Why does no one love me? Except for the British, but they're busy with just everything else. Maybe Provence will be my ally. Nope. Yeah, no, we're on our own. It's a lonely world for Finland. And Scotland actually lost a war to the natives, so that shows you the state that Scotland is in right now. You know, good, yeah. Come on, Scotland, get your shit together. And Norway also lost a war to the natives. So, you know, it's everything's all good with them. Alright, Denmark just embraced. Can't talk today. Denmark embraced global trade. See you. Maybe that means we can soon? We actually have it in Neva. Which means it's going to be speeding up here. We'll be here soon enough in Ingermanland, Viborg. And from there, hopefully it'll spread pretty quick. Hopefully. Back up to 8 loans. Back to where I started this episode. And my inflation, 7.7. I guess I can reduce it a bit. It'll help when I'm, you know, building stuff with my fort maintenance and all. I think, yeah, I should probably get, like, all these next. Go away, train. For God's sake. Manicouagan. Huh. Local settler increase, minus 10%, great. I'm making how much? 4.3 per turn? Even with one colonist? You know what? Screw it. Let's send him. We'll send the extra colonist. Because the bigger my colonial empire gets, the more money I make, damn it. Even if I have to be poor for now, I'll be rich later. As the saying goes, you have to spend money to make money. Okay. When's our truce run out with Denmark again? 31? 5 more years? Too expensive. Denmark's no longer allied with Russia. In fact, they're only allied with Mecklenburg now. So, you know what that means. That means my job got a lot easier, actually. Because I don't have to worry about the great Russian bear anymore. Oliver Cromwell in charge. Over there in the UK. Huh. Is my colonist there yet? Nope, doesn't takes a while. I want to start going into, like, this area, though. Like, New England. You know. And then, oh, good. My colony just became self-sufficient. And so, that way, I can, like, start expanding elsewhere as well. I do want to finish off this area. Let me take a look at my trade zones here. So this is Gulf of St. Lawrence goes down to basically about where Canada ends and the US begins. And yeah. So I could try just to get like all of the Gulf St. Lawrence trade zone first, which might be smarter. Then again, it might not. So, what do I want to do here? I guess I'm gonna start claiming this down here. Gotta go to Micmac, my favorite colony. Anything, I could like start trying to get some other like random islands somewhere. I don't know. I just focus on North America though. Yeah. Yeah, that'll do for now. Let's pay off a loan here. Money's not gonna be doing super great when once this colonist arrives, but as long as our colonies are going fast. We do only get 60 a year per year though, because of the Arctic climate, which whatever. And we can upgrade our military. That'll be helpful. Let's see, we can get some leather cannons and some gallop cavalry. Oops. Oh, great. My favorite event. If only we had Comet Sense. I guess I probably should focus on my military now. Let me take a look at how much Denmark's got. Denmark's got 30,000 total troops. And do I want... I don't necessarily think I need to finish that one off. I might try to go for the next technology, actually. And so, Denmark can have 42 total, which is more than our 39. But as long as, you know, if we could just have a bigger military than Denmark, then we'll be able to take them one-on-one. And assuming we can get our alliance with Brandenburg back, which I think we should, I could probably just go and start improving relations with them again. Because when does that wear off? I think that's... That's, 1634, July. So, 6 more years-ish. That our truce ends in about 3 more years. So we can, I mean, we can wait a few years. We don't have to continually attack Denmark over and over. You know, just wait for a good opportunity first. Hopefully they don't get their alliance back with Russia, actually. Which I'm sure they will. The Ottomans, or Kiva, whoever, may have forced Russia to annul it. Oh, man. Bosnia got annexed. I guess they were in a PU under France, so now France owns this part. I've never seen that before. I've never seen France own that part of the world, actually. That's interesting. That'll probably start some interesting wars with Hungary and Ottomans. France might just go ahead and become the greatest power in the world here, actually. We'll have to see what happens with them. Oh, that was Austria down here for a second. I was about to be like, now that's something I've never seen. Portugal, dang. They just ran right through Mali. And here is glorious Finland. Glorious Finnish imperialistic empire. So beautiful. I'm actually surprised that Russia's not attacking me for Neva and Vyborg. Because it is technically theirs. It's their land. Even though I made the culture Finnish, which is stupid, but whatever. Yeah, money's definitely slowing down a lot because we're spending 4 on colony maintenance here. So hopefully we get through with the colonies pretty quick. I mean, it's definitely going to be a while. 70 per year with a 17% chance on gaining extra guys. Yeah, what's the... Where's the native policy? Where do you see? Impose new tariff, obviously. I forget where I set that. Is that, where the heck do I set my native policy? Here it is. If I do repression, that'll give me 20% more. But obviously that means they can attack me. But if they can attack me... Now, I do have this army wandering around, so they might be willing to help me with that. Because I don't want to have to station troops over here. Where was it? I lost it again. Here it is. I could do this, and then that gives 50% chance to native. Native assimilation. You know what? Screw it. Let's start pressing the natives. And got that technology. So now we're getting 90 a year here, 80 here. So that's definitely going to speed things up a bit. We have a 9% chance of an uprising, but hopefully with our army, with an army walking around. And I'll probably maintain, I think I can maintain like one. Actually, don't. Because then I have to have my army maintenance on, and I don't want to do that. Hopefully just the colonial army will be able to take care of any uprisings we have and stop that from, stop them from killing all of our colonists. Because it's actually a 9% chance per month. That's actually it's actually not a bad chance. Here though, 2%, that might not happen. Yeah. I don't think Humanist Ideas has anything with natives, does it? No, not really. I don't need religious unity because everything's reformed. Whole world is glorious reformed. Actually. Yep, already. Denmark converted these, so we need to convert those back eventually. Come on, you idiots! This is what Do your job. You're supposed to protect the colony. Maybe it wasn't a good idea to do native repression. The good news is, no more uprisings for at least 10 months. Oh god, Russia just joined the war. Denmark attacked us. And the British are helping, but yeah. Don't know if there is much we can do here. I wonder what does Denmark want? They want all my land. They want all of it. Thanks for the gift, Kiva. Not sure it'll matter, but thank you. Let's get down here. Let's start fighting this war that we won't win. Alright, so it looks like the Netherlands is finally just the Netherlands. Except for like a couple provinces. Sadly, Belgium will never be Belgium. Anyways. This may be the end here, guys. If Denmark and Russia take a lot from me in this war, then I don't know if I will have the ability to continue. I'm actually surprised that they're allies together again so quickly. It's actually kind of annoying. Maybe the British will help me though. Maybe we'll win. Probably not. They seem to be content to just sit here and do nothing. We got that though. So we are winning for now. But don't know how long I'll be winning. How much longer? Go to war, obviously. And let's see. Where is the Danish army? I don't have a general again. Hang on. Let's go back up here for a second. Army of Ukraine. And let's Let's hire a leader. Sure, you'll do. Let's go fight the Russians. Maybe we'll win. Maybe we won't. Let's see. Hey, we won! Thank God for severe terrain disadvantages. That's the only reason we won that battle. The British Navy is not even using their full strength, which is why they're losing to the Danish Navy. And their reinforcements just decided to turn around. Awesome. Gosh, I love when the AI is awesome. Huh. Natives are racist, it would appear. Alright, let's go back down to Bolkhusen. Actually, let's go kill those stupid Palatinate army. That's what we really should be doing.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, you better run. Idiots. Maybe the Ottomans will declare war on Russia, like, at this very moment, and then I'll be able to win. What is Denmark's goal even? Reconquest of Helsingland. Huh. Excellent. Don't know what you were expecting there, Mecklenburg, but I appreciate the bravery. Oh gosh, here come the Russians. Nope, they're turning around. Alright, let's go down here to Rival.
And, it might fall before I get there. Oh.
Alright, the British Navy finally decided to do something. Oh no. And okay. That fell pretty quick. Maybe we can take it back even quicker though. There's only 100 men. So you would think that we'd be able to assault and like, you know, like have a decent chance of winning with only 100 men defending the fort, but I guess that's not how this game works. And supposedly the army of Ukraine can totally wipe out my own fortresses way faster than I can wipe out theirs. If that makes sense. Oh look, I won. Alright, let's get down here quick. Might be able to win. Probably not. But might. Come on, terrain disadvantage. Nope, we're not gonna win. Oh, thanks, Ottomans. Wow, I'm so appreciative that you're, you know, of all those subsidies you're giving me. Idiots. Oh, glorious Finland. It's dying. It's many sad. It's a very sad day. Bengal. Ottomans, help. Please. No. Here, Denmark, take my land. No, they want all of my land. No. No. Oh, thanks, Britain. I don't know why you can't just fight for me instead of funding me, but, you know. Thanks, I guess. I'm gonna go up here into the far north where it's cold and the enemy takes a lot of attrition. Oh, looks like Scotland got back all their land they lost to the natives. Good for them. Oh no, I was caught by the Russian army. No. This all gone wrong. Everything's just gone horribly wrong. Yeah, I got nothing. Just take it. Just take it. I give up. I can't. I've lost. It's over! Ah! So that'll be the end of this recording. Please tell me if you want me to even try continuing this campaign. I may start a new one. Maybe I'll do Crusader Kings 2. Maybe I won't do anything. Who knows? Let me know in the comments. And, yeah!